and a little catchy strum pattern are all you need to achieve Watermelon Sugar by Harry Styles. Now, obviously, if you guys didn't know, Miss Kelsey is a huge Harry Styles fan. I recently did a cover of Adore You for the Facebook page for West Chase, so if you haven't given that a look, go ahead and do that. Otherwise, welcome. My name's Miss Kelsey. I'm an instructor at West Chase Music School, and I am very excited to show you guys how to play this awesome song, so stick around and stay tuned. Now, all you need to achieve the Harry Styles song Watermelon Sugar, first off, make sure you have your ukulele or guitar ready to go. What we'll do is I will achieve this on ukulele, but you can comprehend these chords to your guitar if you already know them. But this is a very easy pop song, and one of the catchiest of the year, if I do say so myself. So we're going to start with the first chord, which is D minor. So taking it step by step, you're going to put your first finger on the second string of the first fret, and then you're going to take your middle finger and go to the fourth string, second fret, and then tuck that third finger underneath on the same fret on the third string. So it should look like this, and then you can strum it. So go ahead, find that chord again. So lift your hand up. Now do it again. So 1, 2, 3, strum. Good. Make sure your fingers are not on the line because you don't want to create that buzz. So make sure that you're going ahead and putting your fingers here and setting it there. Now, let's take a second to go ahead and lift again and put our fingers back down. Now, we want to make sure at first it's cool to go ahead and do a 1, 2, 3, but you want to be able to lift and land on the same frets like this without any stacking. So like 1, 2, 1, 2, like lift, put back, strum, put back, lift, strum, lift, strum. So that's how you achieve the D minor chord. The next chord you have is very easy, and all you need to do is lift your 3 and your 1 to leave this middle finger on the second fret of the fourth string to get an A minor. This is your A minor chord. Now lift, now press down, now lift, press down, lift, press down. Cool. Now, the next chord we're going to do is C. Take that third finger, go to the third fret and the first string, and there's your C chord. Lift, put back down, lift, put back down. Ooh, oop. Yep, so this is C major 7, and that's C. So they're not too far behind. But here's C. Lift, put back, lift, put back, lift, put back. Good. The final chord you do is G. Boom, boom, boom. So take your first finger, go to the third string, second fret, then first string, second fret for your second finger, and then third fret, second string for your third finger. Now, if some of you are not able to achieve this rounded hand, drop your thumb on the back so that way you can open up and curl your fingers more. That's usually one of the biggest problems for those that are starting, is making sure that you're achieving this rounded hand position. So, now that we've gone through all four, well, we want to be able to get this G down, because this one's probably the hardest out of all of them. So we want to lift our fingers, and we want to go 1, 2, 3, and strum. Now lift, 1, 2, 3, strum. Lift, 1, 2, 3, strum. Lift. My finger tends to drift here. So one of the things that I like have to make sure is that I'm lifting. Now, you want to make sure when you're doing a G chord that you are stacking it according to going down. So boom, boom, boom. So you're going boom, boom, boom. So boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom, boom. And then just setting it up, lifting, setting it up. This one will take you some time. So if you need to pause and just go over these. So now what I'd like to do is I want to do them in a series of whole notes. So we're going to go D minor, 2, 3, 4, A minor, 2, 3, 4, C, 2, 3, 4, G, 2, 3, 4. But we're going to start a little bit slower than that and we're going to build up. But we're going to do it with whole notes. All right, here we go. 1, 2, ready, go. D minor, 2, 3, 4. And A minor, 2, 3, 4. And C, 2, 3, 4. And G, 2, 3, 4. 2, 3, back to A minor, 2, 3. Now C, 2, 3, 4. Yes, got that. Cool. Now, what we're going to do is we're gonna double it. We're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Again. So we're gonna start from the D minor. 1, 2. Here we go. Let's try it with 4 down strum quarter notes. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 3, 4. And 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, continuing on, now that you've gotten those chords down, let's practice doing it with, like, singing along with the first part. So, 1, 2, 3. Tastes like strawberries on a summer evening, and it sounds just like a song. When you go back into the verse again. So, how did you do on that? Do you need to go back and pause it and do it again? Do that if you have to, but otherwise, let's go on to the next part. So the next part we're gonna do is work on that down strum, or that strum pattern, I should say, up with it. So we're going down, up, down, up, 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 down, up. So, down, down, up. So down, down, up. Down, down, up. up, up, down, up, down. That's the pattern we're gonna go with. So. Now, if that's a little too hard for you guys, there is a step down, and we can always just go. So we could go down, 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 up, down, 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 up, down, 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 up, down, 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 up, down. Tastes like strawberries on a summer evening. Like a song. So either way, don't push yourself to doing a strum pattern that you don't know how to do. If you just need to do whole notes right now, tastes like strawberries on a summer evening, do that. If you just want to do the half notes, tastes like strawberries on a summer evening, or if you want to do the quarter notes. Or, if you want to do eighth notes, tastes like strawberries on a summer evening, down, up, down, up, and just keep going with that. You can even do that too. Either way, there's several options that we have here for you to be able to achieve the song in a way. Now, as far as the whole song goes, it is the same chords in a loop for the entire time. And that is the crazy thing about pop music. It's that you can use the same four chords for whatever kind of setup and you have your song. So with that being said, I want to go ahead and do a run through of it. I know that all of you might not have this down yet, and that's okay. So what I'm going to do for the sake of that is I'm going to do the whole notes. And if you want to go ahead and do whatever strum pattern you want, but I'm just going to keep it nice and easy for everybody so that way you're able to at least run through the chords and see how it goes. Okay? So we're going to do the whole song. And if you aren't as familiar with it, that's okay. I am. So I'm going to be able to guide you through the whole thing. Okay? So here we go. Watermelon Sugar by Harry Styles. One, two, three. Tastes like strawberries on a summer evening, and it sounds just like a song. I want more berries and that summer feeling. It's so wonderful and warm. Breathe me in, breathe me out. I don't know if I could ever go without. I'm just thinking about. I don't know if I could ever go without. Watermelon sugar high, watermelon sugar high, watermelon sugar high, watermelon sugar high, watermelon sugar strawberries on a summer evening. Baby, you're the end of June. I want your belly and that summer feeling. Giving was the way you breathe me in, breathe me out. I don't know if I could ever go without. Watermelon sugar high, watermelon sugar high. Watermelon sugar high, 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 watermelon sugar high. I just wanna taste you, I just wanna taste you, watermelon sugar high. Tastes like strawberries on a summer evening, and it sounds just like a song. I want your belly and that summer feeling. I don't know if I could ever go without watermelon sugar high. 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 End on the D chord, you totally can. So the main thing that we now want to make sure we understand, and I just realized this during the video too, you want to make sure we can also do a loop strum. So we could go down, 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 down. So it depending on, like I said, depending on what level you're at, depending on how you want to set your skill, that ideally is going to be the best way for you to achieve whatever kind of song, whether it's pop, whether it's rock, whether, you know, whatever, starting at, you know, you start at your own level and then you break it down and you build up to your skill level. And that is the thing that certainly will help you, especially with these covers, any cover you do. But otherwise, that is the Watermelon Sugar cover. I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you got to pick up your instrument and practice with this song. Let me know, or let, you know, whatever in the comments, or let us know what, you know, what songs you are curious to learn. All right, now with, you know, with quarantine or with, you know, everything going on in the world, we want to make sure that we're staying entertained, and music lessons are the best way to do that. I definitely feel so happy to be able to help a lot of people through music during this crazy time. So if you are interested in trying a lesson, feel free to call the school at 813-925-0102. Otherwise, if you're interested in learning another song with me on these awesome videos, please let me know. I would love to help, and I would love to continue these, and they're super fun for me to just be able to help out and help you guys, you know, have fun and do almost a sing-along vibe. So take care, and watermelon sugar.